The cash basis and accrual basis are two methods of accounting used to record financial transactions in a business. The cash basis of accounting recognizes transactions only when cash is received or paid out. Revenue is recognized only when it is received in cash, and the expense is recognized only when it is paid in cash. On the other hand, the accrual basis of accounting recognizes transactions when they occur, regardless of when the cash is received or paid out. Revenue is recognized when the goods or services are provided to a customer, even if cash has not been received from the customer yet. The expense is recognized when it is incurred, even if cash has not been paid yet. Let us take an example. During January, ABC sold goods worth $1,000 to a customer. The customer will pay for the goods during February. Here is the income statement for both January and February, first using a cash basis, then using the accrual basis. Under the cash basis, the company sold the goods during January. However, this sale will not be shown as revenues in the income statement for January, as they were not received in cash during January. So, the revenue for January is zero. During February, the company collected this sale in cash, so the income statement for February will show revenue of $1,000. Under the accrual basis, this sale should be reported on the income statement of January, because this sale took place during January, and under the accrual basis, the company realized revenue once the sale transaction was made, regardless of when the cash from sale is received. Let us continue our example. Suppose that the company incurs rent expense of $500 during January, but made the payment on the 1st of February. Under the cash basis, the income statement for January will not show any rent expense as the rent was not paid in cash during January. This expense is shown on the statement of February, the month during which the rent payment was made. Under the accrual basis, the company incurred the rent expense during January, because it already used the leased space during January. So, that expense is shown in the income statement for January, regardless of when the cash payment for that expense was made. So, as you can see, the key difference between the cash basis and the accrual basis of accounting is the timing of when the transactions are recognized. The accrual basis of accounting provides a more accurate picture of a company's financial performance, since it takes into account all transactions, not just those that involve cash, as the case with the cash basis of accounting. That is why the accounting standards require business to use the accrual basis of accounting in the preparation of the financial statements. Now, let us answer the question that was raised in the previous lecture. The sales commission was paid during February, but the salesman sold the goods during January, and earned his commission when the sale was done. So the sales commission expense should be recognized in January, regardless of when it was paid to the salesman. By the end of this lecture, we have covered the important concepts and principles that are the basis for understanding the end of period adjustments. In the following few lectures, we will start discussing the end of period adjustments. So please check the following lecture.